Erectile dysfunction is a very common condition that I help with as an advanced medical practitioner pharmacist practicing in family medicine. So in this video, I'm going to share with you 8 of my very best science-backed tips to help fix erectile dysfunction. So if you're looking for natural erectile dysfunction treatments, then you found the right video. What are we waiting for? Let's dive in. Let's begin with tip number one. To do this, I want to tell you a patient story. I had a patient, middle-aged male, lived a very busy lifestyle. And I want to see if anyone can relate to this. He'd wake up in the morning, go for a shower, sit down and have his breakfast, sit in his car, drive to work for an hour, sit in the office for 8 hours, have his lunch sat down as well, I guess, sit back in his car, drive home for an hour, get home, sit on the sofa, watch TV, and repeat, okay? If anyone can relate to this, there's a reason I'm telling you this story. I genuinely feel like one of the most effective things we can do to help with erectile dysfunction is doing more exercise, because we have such sedentary lifestyles these days. And I'm sure that story a lot of you can relate to. Just 30 minutes of exercise a day, going for a brisk walk, okay? It can help reduce erectile dysfunction by a whopping 41%. But not only that, but if you do more moderate activity exercise, like going for a jog or cycling, for example, it can even restore sexual function. This is particularly for men who are overweight. And the reason for this is really simple. Exercise improves our cardiovascular health, our blood flow. It boosts our testosterone, even nitric oxide. And these are major players in helping you get and maintain a stronger erection. So start moving your body and think about that patient example. See if you can relate to it, because the solution is right there. Stress tip number two is all about strengthening your pelvic floor. We're talking about Kegel exercises, and this can make a massive difference when you have erectile dysfunction. Studies have shown that doing regular Kegels, especially when it's combined with lifestyle changes, which by the way, I'm going to talk about more in this video, can actually lead to firmer and longer lasting erections. So try and incorporate Kegels into your lifestyle. Tip number three, medication. All right, some medication can actually make erectile dysfunction worse. Sometimes it can be the cause for it. The number one medication I see in practice is usually the beta blocker. Now, beta blockers are a big family. One example, for example, is propranolol. Basically, to make it simple, beta blockers affect with the nervous system's ability to actually get and maintain an erection. So what I'm trying to say here is that medication is often one that a lot of people don't think about, because you never think, oh, the medication's going to be causing me this problem. So the most commonly prescribed drugs that might be contributing to erectile dysfunction, so one of them is the beta blockers, another one is thiazide diuretics, and the third one are SSRIs. Now, if you're taking any of these, the advice I'm going to give everyone in this video is do not stop taking any prescribed medication without your medical provider's knowledge, okay? But what I want you to do is this should spark, you know, something in your brain to go and speak to your medical provider, make them aware of it. It might be that actually it wasn't that that's contributing, or it might be that it is, but speak to your medical provider and get guidance from them. Tip four, a major study found that diets that are high in fruit, vegetables, whole grains, and fish can significantly reduce ED. And on the other hand, processed foods and too much red meat can actually make things worse. So this one's a simple one. Nourish your body with healthy whole foods, okay? Do more cooking at home. Avoid ready meals, all right? Everyone knows how to cook and make healthy whole foods. And by the way, it's not just your erections that are going to benefit from this. Your heart will also benefit. If you have any visceral fat, it could reduce as well. So there's a lot of benefits. Stress tip number five, you need to watch your waistline. So here's the numbers. Men who have a 42-inch waist, they are 50% more likely to suffer with erectile dysfunction compared to those with a 32-inch waist. So it's really important to try and maintain a healthy weight. Check your BMI, see if you're overweight, and try and reduce your waist size. And this is also going to help tackle things like diabetes and vascular disease, which are major ED culprits. If losing weight is tough, be sure to watch my videos where I go through the Abraham diet. We have had millions of views on the Abraham diet, and it's helped so many people. It's really easy to do. Everyone can do it at home. Everyone can do it right now. Go and watch the videos. They're really easy to follow, and I hope it helps. Tip number six, let's talk about erectile dysfunction medications such as sildenafil or tadalafil. These are the generic names. You may have heard of the branded names like Viagra, Cialis. Now, they're often a key part of erectile dysfunction treatment, but there's a few things I always tell patients which are really important on how to take them for maximum benefit. One, take them 30 to 60 minutes before anticipated sexual activity. Two, try and take them on an empty stomach. It improves absorption. Three, limit alcohol intake. This can interfere with it. Now, I do have a full guide, a full 5-6 minute video going through lots of detail on every single thing you need to know about sildenafil, about tadalafil, and how to get the maximum effect from it. So if this interests you, go on the channel and give it a watch. Now, if you want more information or treatment options for a particular medical condition, then let me tell you about our very good friends, Dr. Fox. Dr. Fox is an online doctor and pharmacy ready to help with over 30 different medical conditions. And I'd highly recommend visiting their website to learn more about their fantastic services. Link in the description below. Dr. Fox, thank you for being our trusted sponsor. Tip number 7, please be cautious with supplements. Many of the companies, they're not regulated. They're these herbal remedies promising miracles. And worst of all, you never know what's really in them, especially with a lot of these smaller companies. This could also result in side effects, longer-term problems, so be aware of that. Don't risk it, because all of it is really just a placebo effect, even if it has any effect. It's always best to stick with what's clinically proven that works. That's my rant over. Straight on to tip number 8, and it's all about tackling the underlying causes. High blood pressure, high cholesterol, smoking, a lack of exercise, diabetes. These are all major contributors for erectile dysfunction. In fact, over half of men with diabetes experience ED. So if any of these apply to you, have a conversation with your medical provider to make sure everything's controlled and in a healthy range. Getting these under control can lead to real improvements in erectile dysfunction. So there you have it, guys, how to fix erectile dysfunction. We went through the 8 tips. I really hope you found this information helpful. If you have any friends or family or anyone that you know that you think would also find this information helpful, please do share this video with them. And if you can, please leave us a thumbs up, leave us a comment. I always love reading the comments, and we also make videos based on your comments as well. This all helps with the video's performance. Our team, we spend a lot of time making science-backed information really for you guys. So I really hope you found this information helpful, and I'm grateful that you watched it. As we always say at the end of every single week's video, sending awesome vibes, and I'll see you next week.